Hi, this is Yolanda Vanveen, and in this segment, we're going to learn all about transgenic plants. And what is a transgenic plant? There's so many words out there, and it makes you wonder, is this botany or this biology? And the cloning and all the questions and the ethics. But all of that aside, a transgenic plant is just a plant that's been crossed with another plant that has different qualities, and it makes it a stronger plant, or it makes it more drought resistant, or more disease resistant, or more frost resistant. And it's been done very successfully with many different plants. And one of the examples is an LA hybrid plant. And it's a cross with a longiflorum as an Easter lily. They've crossed an Easter lily with an Asiatic plant, which an Asiatic is not fragrant. They're the lilies that come up in the bright, gorgeous colors, but they don't have a fragrance. So they've crossed the two plants and they've come up with a transgenic plant. And that means that the LA hybrids have some of the qualities of both of the plants. So they're two different, totally two different plants that have been crossed. So the key with transgenic plants is they have to be different varieties of different plants. So you can't take the same plant, and sometimes they'll cross naturally. These always cross usually in a laboratory, and they take the cells or they cross them. But they can also do it just by taking, what they do is take the pollen from one plant and just put it on the stylus of another plant, and that produces seeds that has the two qualities of the other plant. It does happen naturally. But in the case of the LA hybrids, what's happened, they crossed the Asiatics and the Easter lilies, and they've come up with a lily that has more chromosomes than people. So they have the ultimate number of chromosomes. And what happens is it makes them very frost tolerant. They can live in Alaska really well. Whereas a lot of the trumpet lilies can't survive in Alaska, but the Asiatics can. But by crossing the two, they've created a lily that is like the most strongest lily in the world. It is stronger than an Asiatic. I've heard reports of minus 50 degrees and they can survive, when a trumpet lily can't even survive minus 10, minus 20 generally. So there's a lot of ethics involved too. A lot of grapes, they're crossing different plants with grapes, and they're even realizing that with wheat, they cross it with a bacteria that is found on moths, or a part of a DNA from a moth, and they actually put it into the plant. And what has happened, they've made a disease-resistant plant that's also a lot of times bug-resistant. So transgenic really isn't that mysterious. It just means crossing two plants to make a better plant. Yeah.